Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's your bro. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can accept some user input in Java. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. One like equals one prayer for the YouTube algorithm. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to explain how we can use a scanner to accept some user input. The scanner class is found in the Java utility package of your library, and we need to import that before we can use this scanner. So outside of the class, at the top of our program, this is what we're going to type. Import java.util, and the name of the class we would like to import, which is scanner. Then a semicolon. Now we can use the scanner class to create a scanner object. So we're going to be performing a little bit of object-oriented programming. We'll be covering object-oriented programming in a later part of the series, so don't worry. So repeat after me. Scanner, then we need a name for the scanner. Let's call it scanner, all lowercase, equals new scanner. Then a set of parentheses and a semicolon. Within the parentheses, we're going to type system.in. And there we go. We have our scanner. So we can use the scanner to accept some user input. So let's let the user know that we would like them to type in something, maybe a name. Let's create a prompt that will ask somebody for their name. So within a println statement, we'll type, "What is your name?" And next, what we'll do is take our user input and assign it to a variable, perhaps a string variable called name. String name equals, and now we're going to use our scanner. So we type in the name of the scanner, dot, and to enter a line of text, we're going to use a certain method of the scanner. It is the nextLine method. And when we type in user input, we type it into the console window here at the bottom. So let's do something with this name. Maybe display this within a message. System.out.println, hello, plus whatever your name is. So let's compile and run this. What is your name? Now our program is currently paused until we type in some user input and then press the enter key. When you press enter, that's how you submit some user input into the console window. So I'm going to click within my console window and type in something. I'm going to type in bro, and to submit some user input, you press the enter key. And it states hello plus my name, which is what I entered, bro. Now there's different types of input that we can accept. This time, let's accept only an integer number. Perhaps we can ask somebody for their age. So let's write a prompt for that. System.out.println. How old are you? And this time we will declare an integer variable, maybe called age. Int age equals scanner.next. And we are looking for int. So we can only accept a whole integer. You are plus age plus years old. Okay, let's try this again. What is your name? Bro, how old are you? Let's just say that I'm 18. Hit enter. Hello, bro. You are 18 years old. So what happens if we do not enter in a number? So let's try and break this. What is your name? Bro, how old are you? We're not going to enter a number this time. Let's type in the word pizza and see what happens. Well, we encountered an exception. We encountered an input mismatch exception because when our scanner is looking for an integer, we typed in a string. So we need to make sure that the input type, the data type, matches. In a future lesson, we'll be covering exception handling, where we can prevent this very thing from happening. But for now, since we're beginners, we'll just have to be sure to type in the correct data type of the input that our program is looking for. Now, there's one more thing that I want to show you guys. This is a common problem if you use next line after next int or anything else that's not next line. So let's ask somebody for their favorite food this time. So let's add that at the end. System.out.println, what is your favorite food? Then we'll create a string variable called food. String food equals scanner.nextLine. And we will display this. System.out.println, you like plus food. All right, so here are the questions. What is your name? Bro, how old are you? 18. Now pay attention to this when I press enter. When we reached the question on what is your favorite food, well, our program skipped our user input and continued on with the rest of the code. So it states, hello, bro, you are 18 years old, but we were not able to input anything for our favorite food. Here's the reason why. Here's what's going on. Let's pretend that this box is a representation of our scanner, and we're going to use the next line method of our scanner to read a line of text. So we type in our name and then press the enter key to submit. So this backslash n is an escape sequence for a new line. The next line method will read an entire line of text and stop when it reaches a new line character. So after we call the next line method, our scanner is going to be empty. However, if we were to call a different method that doesn't read a new line character, such as nextInt, so we type in our input, such as the number 18, and then press the enter key, that will add a new line character. So our nextInt method is only going to read this numeric portion of our scanner, and then when we submit it, well, this new line character is still going to be within our scanner. And if we were to use our scanner again and call a different method, like nextLine, well, our nextLine method thinks that we're at the end because there's this new line character within our scanner. So we would need some way to clear out that new line. One easy fix for this is that after you call the nextInt method, what we could do is call the nextLine method to clear our scanner. So I'm just going to copy this portion and paste it. We're not really going to do anything with that new line character. This will just clear the scanner for us. So now we should be able to answer all three questions. So type in your name. What is your name? It is bro. How old are you? Let's say I'm 18. What is your favorite food? And you can see that it paused this time, unlike the first time. And my favorite food is pizza. Press enter. Hello, bro. You are 18 years old. You like pizza. Well then, that is one way in which you can use a scanner to accept some user input. Scanners are capable of much more. You can also use them to read the contents of a file and a few other things, but we'll learn about those in future videos. And if you need to use a scanner, be sure to include this import at the top, import java.util.Scanner, because the scanner class is found within the utility package, and then you'll need to create a scanner object just by following these steps. Scanner, you can call it scanner, equals new scanner. Well, guys and gals, that is how scanners work in Java. Before you go, I would greatly appreciate it if you could do a favor for me and like this video, leave a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.